So let's look at the frame that we're going to analyze in this video. It's just a two-member frame. And up here, I have a roller. And down here, I have a pin connection. It's metric. There's a 4 kilonewton load up here going down. And there's this distributed load right here of 1.5 kilonewton meters that's going this direction to the left. So the first thing you should do is draw a free body diagram. A free body diagram, I'll say it again. And it just shows the forces that we're looking for. There's an unknown AX, I'm going to assume that it's going to the right. There's a CX and a CY. So those are the forces we need to solve for. First thing I would do is solve for the forces in the Y direction. And I'm going to say up is positive, and I'm going to sum the forces equals zero. I've got 4 kilonewtons acting down. I've only got CY acting up. That has to equal zero. It's in equilibrium. CY equals 4 kilonewtons. Next thing I'm going to do is figure out AX. So I'm going to sum the moment around C. So I'm summing the moments around C. So none of the forces are working in that area right there. Sorry, it seems to be going a little crazy. So what do I have? I have AX, and AX is acting this distance away, which is 16 meters, right? It always acts at a 90 degree angle. And the 4 kilonewtons is acting down, and its distance away is 8 meters. So if you look at it, it's 8 meters right here. And then I've got the 1.5 kilonewtons here, acting over a distance of 10 meters, and the centroid from C is 6 meters plus half, so 11. That's the centroid of the force. Solving all that for AX, I get AX is 12.3125 kilonewtons to the right. And the last thing, I'm going to sum the forces in the X direction. And if I do that, I've got AX minus this load up here plus CX, the only thing left unknown. And I solve for that, and I get CX is equal to 2.6875 kilonewtons. So simple frame. So give it a try. So let's take a quick look at this in SketchUp. So this is what I want to show, is that it's a frame we're analyzing. We're not just analyzing lines. So let's look at it. I've got a point load coming down on the beam, and I've got a distributed load going on the column. So I'm going to say down here at C that this connection is a pin connection because it's a lot of bolts, but it can probably still take a little bit of rotation and you don't need much to have a pin. So I got a little space in there between the column and the footing. So I'm going to say that's a pin connection. Now the members are tied together really well, so I'm going to say this is a moment connection, meaning that a moment can be resisted by this connection and I can have a moment at this point. And that keeps the frame rigid for our analysis. On the left, I've got a roller, and you can look at it. It can go up and down, but it can't go to the left. And ideally, I would secure it so it can't go to the right either. So it's just resisting a force in the X direction. All right, this is kind of what I want it to look like. So pin down here on the right, roller up here on the left, and this is a moment connection to keep the whole frame rigid. And it kind of looks like that. So remember, when you're analyzing things, it's just not a line, it's a piece of a building, it's a piece of a frame. So the last thing I want to try and do is do this in STAAD. So let's go new project, meter, kilopound, well, let's go kilonewton, that's what I want. I want a plane structure, and I'm just overwriting a dummy file. And I'm going to add a beam, okay, let's do that. Again, I don't like this grid very much, so I'm just going to ignore it. And I'm just going to go fast. So it already put something in. So what do I want? I want 0, 16. That's my first piece. Then I want 12, 16. And I'm just putting in the coordinates. So, and the next one's 12. So let's get out of that. Let's get out of that. You can see my points. A little hard on the screen, but let me put the members in. I'm gonna go rather fast, so you can watch some of my other videos. Needs a property for a moment of inertia and a modulus elasticity. I'm just gonna randomly pick one and assign it. I'm gonna go to support, pick a support, go create, P, pinned, assigned, and then I'm going to go over here, create, enforce but. The only thing I want it to do is the X, so I'll say everything else is free to do whatever it wants, assign. Then I'm going to go to loads, load cases, new, and I'm going to create load case one. And then I'm going to add the loads in. And I'm just going to go to member loads. So the first one is a uniform force, minus four. And it's occurring D1 away, which is 4 meters, and add. And it's in the global Y. I also want, let's go back to the load case, close. Let's add one more, a member load. This time my uniform, where is it? Force of minus 1.5. And it's going to occur, you look at it, D1 is 0, but D2 is 10 meters. And it's in the global X. So let's make sure I do that. Close. Now I can select the member I want, select the force I want, assign to selected beams. Yes. Select the beam, or column in this case, the load, assign. And then I can turn it on to see what it looks like. And I've done it wrong, right? So the best way to do that sort of thing is you can go to the input file, and somehow it gave me a uniform force, and that's not what I want, so I'll save that, and I'll go back to this, and add back a load case that I must have screwed up. So I want a member load, concentrated force, minus 4, D1 is 0, no, D1 is 4 in the global Y. So somehow it doesn't seem to like that one too much, and I'm not sure why. Let's see what's going on here. There it is. Labels, load value, okay. All right, analysis, add, close. You can see everything's in the tree. Go to analyze. A lot of saving. They don't want you to lose your data. And I'm done. Let's go to post-processing. Reactions. And what do I have? Well, there's the 12.312, right? It rounds it up. You can change that. And down here, I've got 4 in the Y direction. That's what I want. And 2.688 in the X direction, which is what I want. And I can turn the loads back on. And I can flatten it out. And you can see how everything looks. Then you can play around with other things, graphs, moments, all sorts of things. Give it a try. I went really fast, but stop it when you need to, and then you'll get the hang of it. Thanks a lot.